Hello Riggers, I'm Maximiliano Ramirez de Leon, generalist animator and animation director in this project. Today I'm gonna share with you two amazing rigging tools that will allow us save much more time to animators when they manipulate the characters. The first one is the 2 points constraint node that will allow us implement the inverse kinematic system to our extremities. The second one is the master controller system, a useful tool that will allow us to create a controller to set the angle of the face. Of course, these tools can't be implemented in only one step, so this tutorial requires basic knowledge in the Toon Boom animation program. Also, it's important to say that some of these tools are not available in every Toon Boom versions, so I recommend update at least to the Harmony 20 Premium version. Without nothing more to say, let's begin. The first thing to do is import our character turnaround sheet. Usually we have 5 views, but we can complete the turnaround just flipping the scale in x-axis. Center every view in their respective frame thanks to the guides. It's important to have a high-resolution bitmap because these drawings will be the position reference of every drawing and the former vectors. Let's begin drawing. We need to have every element of the character in a different drawing node or layer. You can organize however you want, but be sure that animators will find the nodes easy. So name every node, it's important. Some of my nodes are in Spanish and almost of my pegs are now named, but do what I said, not what I do. You can set a background for several nodes to make much more easy to animators know their position in the node editor. And once we have drawn all our front view of our character, it's when we can start implement our inverse kinematic system. Create a 2-point constraint node and connect it to the draw that will be affected. What this node do is bring the translate and deformation property to a draw being affected by the position of the pegs connected above. This one will act as the anchor point, so you can do this even with the neck and belly, and every part you think must have an automatic movement. So, unlike forward kinematic input, with inverse kinematic we only have to worry about one rotation value instead of 3. But in this specific case there are 2 draws that need to have this node, so let's create another one. We're gonna create a peg and set his position where the extremity begins. Later we're gonna create another where extremity ends and start the next one. And a third peg for the ankle. We don't need to create a new peg for the next draw, because these have the same position where the next one starts. So this will also be connected to that 2 points constraint node. We want that middle peg also moves under the influence of the sides ones. So we're gonna create another 2 point constraints for him. And let's change these values to 200 and 100. The last peg that we need to connect also already exists. It's the draw that will control the entire extremity. To make the knee falls, we're gonna need to create a transformation limit. Let's connect the transformation limit to the right part and change all these values to 0. Now, if we press this button to show the controllers or the command Shift F11, we're gonna see a red pivot that allows us to choose the direction of the fold. So this is essentially all what you need to do. Of course, if you want to implement this in the neck, you only need to create 1 2-point constraint node. You will create the pegs that will move it and parent those pegs with your already existing draws. Possibilities are endlessly. But considering that now articulations are parented to establishment pegs, you will realize that complete the turnaround will be a little bit hard, especially because you're gonna need to draw hands over a rigged arm. But there's many ways to avoid this, like draw the complete views of the fist in the first frame, but in different drawing layers, of course, to avoid drawing without knowing where is the pivot. You can parent more draws to these nodes and even use deformers over them. Remember, always be testing, because you can find some issues that are easy to fix, like this arm who deforms when falls, and it's easy to fix just choosing a different position of the limit transformation pivot. And this way, helped by the turnaround sheet, you will fit every extremity in his position. You will need to move pegs in Z-axis to have the arms over the chest, for example, when you work with side views. You can use the bone tool to see always where the pivots are if you are drawing over rigged parts. You can also find these glitches in the joints, but are easy to solve just changing the flatten type option to translate to plane. To start with the master controller system steps, we're gonna need to have all our face drawing layers and deformers already seted, at least in the front view and with their peg pivots centered. As you can see in this example, I put guides where I know the face must be folded. Apply deformers to face, it's complicated since we can't flip the deformers because we always need to show the A face of the silhouette. So the right side vectors will always gonna be the right sides and the left sides the left ones. So this means we gonna need to create enough vectors even in the drawing as in the deformers when we need to move to the turnaround views. Instead of flip, we're gonna set the deformer's vectors in a position that resembles the opposite side. As you can see in this example, I'm using a red line as a reference, cause my turnaround don't have enough resolution. So this way I've flipped the face successfully. Once we start moving through the views, we realize that we need to fit a lot of things, like squash the eyes to get that effect of turning the face, and of course we're gonna need to mask all the elements with the face layer. You can use a plus and minus key to expand or contract the spaces between the keyframe columns in the timeline. This way you can see better the transition of the pegs. But do it only after select all with Ctrl A, or you're gonna mess it all. The amount of things you have to do to rig a character properly can be scary. With the time you will find your own ways to save time in some steps, like prepare a skeleton already rigged just to replace the drawings. Now it's time to implement the master controllers. We're gonna select all the nodes that we want to be affected by the slider. And we're gonna put the number 1 in the first frame and the number 9 in the last one. This to have a complete turnaround. And for the stack wizard controller, we're gonna create a copy of all our views. And we're gonna start to manipulate the rig to make it look up in every copied frames. And a tiered copy to manipulate and make it looking down. Now we open our Stack Wizard controller and we start setting the drawings, making double click in these dots. Of course, the middle one may be the front view, the next one the frame number 2, the next one the 3, and of course the up one may be the looking up pose, and below one the looking down. We're gonna name the file and create.